As a guy who is a Canucks fan, a Leafs fan, and a Habs fan, this kind of video is my territory. So, talking about the Montreal Canadiens and free agent D-men, a lot of people have been bringing up the UFA D-men market and how this needs to be the plan here. That UFA free agents, they're going to be available, left-handed D-men are going to be available, and Habs fans and Habs media outlets are talking about a few of these guys in particular. I saw this on the Montreal Gazette, I saw this on Last Word on Hockey. This is something that people have been talking about. Let's go over the Toronto Maple Leafs' Jake Gardiner and the Vancouver Canucks' Alex Edler. These are two left-handed free agent defensemen who are projected to being on the free agent market. Now, I will say, just on a little bit of a disclaimer here, that some of these guys, one of them in particular, is going to be more guaranteed to stay on his previous NHL team than the other. But without further ado, let's just go over what either of these two guys could provide the Habs if Montreal decides to go for them. Now, just getting the similarities out of the way here first, if both of these guys hit the free agent market, and if one of them is available, the Montreal Canadiens would probably need to spend upwards of around $5+ million to land one of these guys, maybe even getting into that $6 million territory. For Gardiner specifically, there has been this idea throughout the season saying that he would go for upwards of $7, maybe $7.5 million. Now, I'll leave it up to you to judge whether or not you believe that's worth it or not, but for Alexander Edler and Jake Gardiner, you're gonna have to give up $5.5+ and maybe even upwards of $6 million. And if you're looking at that from the Montreal Canadiens' point of view, it's very easy to accommodate with that. The Habs do have loads of cap space, which is kind of why this idea has been brought up. Moving on to them individually though, let's start off with the guy who is more likely to head to free agency, and that is Jake Gardiner, formerly, or at least currently, who knows, of the Toronto Maple Leafs. This season with the Toronto Maple Leafs, Jake Gardiner was a half a point a game player. 30 points in 62 games played. That's on pace for approximately 40-ish points. 2 years ago, in 2017-2018, Gardiner had his career high of 52 points in 82 games. The year before that, 40 points in 82 games as well. So, Gardiner is a guy who can consistently put up upwards of 30 to 40 points, depending on how many games he plays, and depending on his mojo, he can hit 52. So, Gardiner is certainly a guy who can have some great offensive prowess if he comes over to the Montreal Canadiens. The biggest con to Gardiner that people will call out consistently, no matter who you are, a fan of any team, it's his defensive play and his clutch. Now, if I'm going to be honest, as a Leafs fan, watching Gardiner this season, he's been a pretty good defenseman. I'm not going to sit here and say that he sucks defensively, and I'm not going to sit here either and say that he's amazing. But I will say that Gardiner has found a way to always have his worst game at the most important time. And if I'm going to be honest, truthfully speaking, Gardiner is pretty good defensively. He's not amazing, but he's pretty alright. It's just that his offensive game is his true spotlight. And honestly, if you take Gardiner and you pair him with a guy like Shea Weber, you're covering up those defensive lapses quite a bit, and honestly, you have a pretty good pairing. Gardiner is a guy whose offensive instincts could thrive with a guy like Shea Weber on his side, and Weber is Weber, so he's pretty alright at covering for Gardner's mistakes. So ultimately, I believe taking a look at Gardiner and what he has to offer, it's unfair to look at the bad moments that Gardner's had in Toronto and be like, yeah, no, that's Gardiner. That's the Gardiner that we're going to get if we sign him to the Montreal Canadiens. Because honestly, Gardiner in his 82-game schedule is pretty all right. He's not terrible, which is kind of the point I'm trying to drive home here. And when you take a look at it, he's a guy who could mesh well with a guy like Shea Weber. So Gardiner, if he comes to Montreal, I could honestly see him having a good solid tenure, offensively speaking, putting upwards of 40-45 points a year with the guys in front of him, with Shea Weber on his side, and as a number one, maybe even a number two, power play quarterback. But the thing that you have to worry about when it comes to signing Gardiner is the fact that he is 28 turning 29. He's going to want this contract of his to be his retirement contract. This is the last contract of his career, foreseeably speaking. This is the contract that he's going to live the rest of his life based off of. So you're going to have to go long term, and you're going to have to go upwards of $6, maybe even $7 million to land this fish. Because if you're not going to pay Gardiner $7, $6.5 million, then some other team will. And that's kind of why Gardiner is a guy who's going to be worth this amount of money, because he's this age and because he will most likely retire on this money. Now that's Jake Gardiner for you, Habs fans. This is how he would pair out with the Montreal Canadiens, in my opinion. And that's all fine and dandy, but let's go over the other guy who people are talking about could potentially sign with the Habs if he hits the free agent market. That is Vancouver Canuck Alex Edler. Now, I just wanted to say here, first of all, that Edler making the free agency market is much more unlikely than Gardiner making the free agency market. If you're not a Vancouver Canucks fan like I am, you might not know the context behind Alex Edler and why exactly it's taken this long to get him signed to a contract. Edler has been expiring the whole year, and that's kind of something that everybody kind of knew. At the same time, Canucks fans were kind of asking the question on whether or not it would be nice to trade Edler at the trade deadline, potentially for something back. Because he was on the expiring deal, and because he wasn't at a contract extension, people were saying, okay, trade Edler, make him a rental, get some assets back, and then maybe sign him again in the offseason, who knows? That seemed like a pretty suitable plan, but Alexander Edler nixed a few trades, specifically one to the Calgary Flames, because he has that no trade clause, so he had the option to do so. Basically speaking, the Canucks couldn't trade him because he wanted to stay. And the whole connotation around him staying was the fact that he does have kids, he does have a wife, he does have a life here in Vancouver, and he expressed several times how he loves it here and how he wants to stay here going forward. And he's been very open about that for the past few weeks. And going over what it is the free agency market has to offer, people are kind of starting to take a look at it and say, okay, it's not really a matter of if the Canucks are going to re-sign Edler, but a matter of when. And I think a lot of these outside Toronto, Montreal, other NHL outlets looking at this and looking at Edler specifically, I don't think a lot of people know the context behind Edler and his status as a potential UFA, but in my opinion, I think it's way more likely that Edler stays as a Vancouver Canuck rather than him going to free agency. If I had to say the odds, it's probably 70-30 that he stays in Vancouver over going to the free agent market. But Habs fans, weirder things have happened before, so let's talk about Alexander Edler if he goes to free agency and if he goes over to the Habs. Alex Edler is a guy who I'm going to admit is not necessarily the healthiest among Vancouver defenders. He's never played a full 82-game season. He's always got something going on, and usually it's not something that's good. But regardless, Alexander Edler did have a pretty good year this year. 34 points in 56 games played. This was one of his better seasons in a while, and the fact that he got 10 goals, which is tied for his second best season ever, was quite remarkable for us Canucks fans. Edler really started to come alive this year. He got 34 points in 70 games two seasons ago, so matching that up in 56 games this year was pretty good. Edler is a guy who's pretty defensively sound. He's pretty much been one of our main PK guys this season on the back end, alongside of Chris Tanev, who also didn't play that many games. But Edler himself has been pretty solid on both ends of the ice. I don't want to sit here and say that he's really good at any one specific thing, but I will say that he has refined his game and he plays a really mature style that translates well across all areas of the ice. The only nitpick I have on Edler is the power play, because he is the guy who usually does the drop pass, and I get it, everybody does the drop pass, it's the plan of the team, but Edler's power play creativity in the zone wasn't necessarily one of the best strengths, in my opinion. I felt that he was kind of lackadaisical on the power play, he kind of waited around a little bit, but I do believe that Edler on a good team, on a speedy team, on a team with different systems than the Vancouver Canucks, could totally thrive in a number one, but probably more in a number two power play role. Edler, though, is a solid defender, he can put up points, he can do things on the PK, and overall, he's a pretty good team presence to have. He's had the A on the Vancouver Canucks sweater for a while now, and going into free agency, if he does go to free agency, he's probably going to be able to get himself upwards of $6.5 million, depending on which team overpays for him. However, Jim Benning and the Vancouver Canucks have made it every one of their intentions to re-sign Alex Edler and keep him on the team. We already talked about his family, his love for the city, and why I believe personally that he's probably going to stay in Vancouver over going into free agency. But if he does go into free agency, the Montreal Canadiens, they could probably use a guy like Edler, a solid, reliable left-handed D-man. And that's ultimately what the Canadiens could use a lot more of, right? Left-handed D-men. There's certainly going to be some available in free agency, and we covered two of them in this video. Hope you enjoyed this video. Social Gaming, and bye.